I'm gonna win my caliper. No, no. I'm paying attention to where the tape goes. Sorry, I thought you knew what window stuff. So, just measure from there. That's supposed to be there. See this end? So, we're gonna extend it from here up to the center of the bar. 9 inches. Say 10 now. Because that'll give us some slack in the hose a little bit, right? But I just need a solid line. This hose, see, will only gonna go about here. And from here up, I'm gonna have just a solid line going up into this. We undo this right here, and we'll put it between here and here. This will be up here, this will stay right here, this is jumping up to here, and in between we're gonna put a steel line like that. So you have in a car. I did it before on my other bike that way. Or unless, when I can spring the money for it, we'll get a brand new hose, because this one is rubbed through right there, remember? But I just want to get the parts picked up off of this bike for now, now that I know everything's going to work. So 10 inches. What we got to do, stuff these. Oh, thank you. Stuff these sort of back into it, I guess, for now. We know how much we got. I don't know where they're going in there. They're going into that cavity, I guess. I should look at them. More worried about the bike needs a paint job. Just drop that tape and hold them to it. I'm more worried about banging those switches up here than anything. We don't want scratches against, but this other girl needs. I never like the color of it. Okay, so we need to get that one. We'll reseal the barrels, right? Okay. Well, grab a 9/16. It's probably here. There's some stuff here. That ratchet and that extension. And the 9/16 suck. That ratchet, that extension, and the 9/16 suck, that thing. It's still over there, right? This is just stuff I was playing with. It should be over there, Matt. 9/16. Slide that thing off too for now. Give it a twist and slide it off. Put it on the other bar. Back to stock for now. You know what we need. We need to order some parts. On. You can just put on one at a time, which is kind of neat. Factory stainless bar, right? And they're open and everything. We don't know exactly. So, like I say, we can build one at a time here. See, with the fairing on it, if you have to have the tip sort of tipped down, with the fairing off, I may be able to run them up a little bit. Probably put the fairing on too. It does away. Yeah, I think. Fairing, I had like that. It's just kind of getting a feeling out of how the edges. Anyway, Take your ratchet and lock them down right there like that. We gotta pull them back down because the fairing, see, comes up high. This will hit the mounts on the fairing. That's good for now. We're gonna double check them. Before we cover this up, we'll double check the tightness on them. I think these may have to be moved, put the fairing up, just to feel up higher than. I never rode this bike much about the fairing. Okay, so that goes there, and of course you don't need that in your hand anymore right now. Now we need a Allen wrench. And an Allen wrench and four of the behind you on that table, there's some stainless steel screws and the Allen wrench to fit them, basically. And put the thing back on, the control back on. It's there somewhere on, it's already out, maybe here. Long black one. Two of them there. See the small one of the two, is there two there? Or was there just one there?
There's two there.
Okay, so you'll have to hold this for a minute while I fiddle with this switch. Too much of that in there. So that goes like that. This is the trickiest part always, is trying to get this plug back in. See, those two things, you're supposed to plug them into that thing. Maybe I can get it with you here. Yeah, let's put that down for a second. It's all right if this is up here like this. Let me try this. It's got to be turned. Some slack. Yeah, and it doesn't pull itself off, but the drag, I don't know how long or if that'll stay on there. It's coming off again anyway when we put the apes on it. I got it. Okay, now the problem is, no, you don't need that yet, but just put that back down again. I need you to hold the, now you gotta hold the, see that this is together, put those down, you need two ends. Not ready yet. I want you to hold this thing here, pull that towards you, just this part. I got this part. I gotta get this right there. Okay, I got it again now. Okay, put a screw in the top there, bud. A couple screws in the top. Yes, dangerous there. Yep, not tight. Okay, put the other one in. That's good. Something like this with four screws, once you start drawing, you want to draw it together. You want to stop for a minute, because you could draw it completely in and break something. You got to have a look at everything. Put the other ones in. I actually had that orange wire in here. Why it was giving me grief. Okay, put the other one in. That feels good. Yeah. Oh, that's good. Well, what I like to do is close the top up. Let's put the throttle on first. And we bring this back to the throttle. So now you need a Phillips screwdriver. What did we do with that one yesterday? Black handle Phillips screwdriver. I had it though, but I might have put it away
right here. I got it. Yeah, I'm just looking for my hat. Oh.
put it somewhere I can't find it. Maybe.
Okay. So.
You gotta move that. I just like to position this. Is all. That should be like that, right? That's down like that. Okay, you come and tighten these screws right here. Right about like that, yeah. The old screws are original for 77, so they're not the greatest of shape, but there it is. You gotta get a longer one, that's all. Now this thing, you got your Allen wrench with you?
Yep.
This comes down against it, and that's why I like to be sitting on the bike, because I like to get this where I can run the starter switch and everything. You know, you don't want it to weigh up like this, and you don't want it weighing, you know, you don't want it like that, right? So you got to have them sort of facing you and
in good position.
Yeah, one you can operate the blinker on, because these blinkers, you don't, you got to hold them for them to work. All right, I like to tighten the top first, and it closes the gap up on this, right? You don't want water running in there if you can help it. So I figure I close the top, and then I tighten more on the bottom. Because it won't fully come together on the bottom. It's not designed to do that. So there. Now, I want to make sure these wires are not pinched in any way. It feels good. Put that down there like that. Yeah, that's good for now. So, I like the position of that. We'll snug it down. Everything still works and everything's tight.
Sounds like it.
Yeah, well, you want, I'm looking for it to spring back, right? Mm. You want the throttle sticking on you. And I think I got that wrapped around different than what I did I had originally. That was probably on top of this. Follow me?
Yep.
So we don't have that, but that's fine. Once I put the fairing, once I put the fairing on, it's gonna hide it. Go ahead.
Easier for you switching, I guess.
What?
Easier for you to switch them?
Switch them is what you said. I couldn't understand that part of what you were just saying there. I can straighten it out when I switch them. That's right. Shouldn't have jammed that in there so much. It's dumb. Now, this one, same deal. Two halves. It's got to go in the right position. Yeah, that's right.